Fucking thing sucks!
There we go.
We'll do it live.
Welcome back to Cruise Mistake. Grimstake here, coming at you live on Grimerica FM. It is Tuesday, October 13th.
Excuse me.
We've got an incredible show coming at you tonight, guys. Probably some of the most insane stuff you've ever heard in your life. We've planned up. It's coming. All the truth, all the facts. Gonna solve it all.
Lots of trust.
Tons of trust.
Trusting this, hard.
This is normally where I'd introduce James Cruz, but he's so stuck in a technological vortex right now. He'll be here
James
sooner
Cruz.
Or later.
James Cruz.
Either a computer, phone, one way or another. He's swimming through the ether. He'll make it.
You're fired.
And we also got Jerry Cthulhu.
Hey boys, how you doing?
Great.
And ladies, lady.
Hi Jerry.
Hi Suzanne.
And we also got B.Strut.
Happy Tuesday, guys. I love you.
Love you, Bill.
A new episode of 13 Questions came out with Marty Leeds. If you guys remember that I booked Marty on the show about like a year ago.
That is true.
And that was like the first time I came on the show. So that's kind of special.
Man, you should go check it out. It's full circle.
What do you want? A fucking back rub? Shut up.
Yeah.
I want to give
better than
rub.
Making charity pies or whatever. Bullshit you did, Jerry. No, I'm just kidding.
Cherry
pies.
Hell yeah. Cherry pies. What?
Apple pies.
Oh. And we also got Flavortown.
Flavortown.
There it is. And we got Nickie the Dude.
James Cruz.
And we got Zac Hawkins.
Oh, shit. Remember, kids, no matter where you go, there you are.
Wisdom.
Okay. There it is.
And we have Suzanne.
Hello.
Hey, Suzanne. Hey. There it is. Got it, guys.
So, masks.
So, yeah, let's get right into it, guys.
Let's dive in. We need to go hard on masks. I'm not even going to wait.
So, I saw four people riding bikes with fucking masks on.
Oh, my fucking
God. Tell you all about it.
How about people in cars driving around with masks
all the time? I don't think we've ever brought that up on the show.
Really?
Damn. Really? Wait, hold on. Well, hold on. Let me go back to the archives. Let's look into this.
Look in the wiki.
So, Trump and Chris Christie both got COVID and both survived like within days. So can we just please open the fucking country back up?
Wait, 34 people in the White House got coronavirus.
So they're all dead, and we have a new White House?
No, they're all fine.
Damn.
Fine.
Damn. I don't understand. What is this fine you speak? Oh, shit.
They have better health care than we do.
Yeah.
Or it's not very deadly.
Or maybe. We don't want to take those chances.
Yeah, what's up with this thing that they keep calling Regeneron? I don't like the name of that. That sounds like it should be the name of something that is made by Umbrella Corporation.
Right? I was going to mention a fucking zombie movie or...
I think it's an asthma drug.
Dude, it's just bleach.
That's all it is.
It's a form of bleach.
It's just a Tide Pod. You just light
Trump
up.
Was right the whole time, man.
Free
inject
basic.
Yourself with bleach, you're good. You got to bleach your insides.
He never said that.
No, obviously he didn't, Jerry. That's the joke, though. It's so funny because he did it.
Regeneron might just be like the brand name for adrenochrome.
It might.
Well, they said it's a. They say it's an antibody. What if it's an? What if it's a anti baby?
Well, they say that they don't put aborted fetuses in it, but I gotta look it up because John's trying to find.
They don't.
There's aborted fetuses in everything.
Aborted fetuses.
That's a myth. That's not true. They use stem cells. I don't want to like defend the fucking vaccine industry, but they're not aborted fetus cells. They're just stem cells.
Your shirt says I stand vaccines.
From aborted fetuses.
That's right.
I think we split aborted fetus hair here.
Is that a yeah. guy from the vaccine companies coming and handing you a huge check behind you, Jerry?
They're totally safe. Get every vaccine you can.
Pfizer shirts.
My cousin actually works for Pfizer. My cousin-in-law, I suppose.
Oh, damn. It's it all makes sense.
Jerry's been co-opted.
No, I haven't talked to him in years. Yeah, that's me. The fucking Pfizer show.
I mean, statistically speaking,
the dude wouldn't even come across with any Viagra. Okay, so
Well, fuck him.
Screw him then.
You just get Blue Chew these days. You don't even need Viagra. Yeah.
This was 20 years ago.
Yeah,
Blue Chew. What the hell's that?
Sorry, Flavortown.
I don't remember anymore. I'm sorry. I just took
that
a hit.
Orphan train has left
well,
the
you know,
station.
You take a hit and then you have a good idea and then you have to not think about that idea for a minute and then you do again. It's over.
It's the life of a
exactly.
pothead, man. The life of a pothead.
Better fucking write it down.
Yeah.
The life of a pothead is forgetting the world's best ideas over and over again. That's all you're doing.
Yeah. I think I'm getting Alzheimer's. I can't remember anything anymore.
All right, things aren't worth remembering. It's because we're not on base timeline, and there's no consensus reality, and everything's just spiraling. No. So it's things don't make sense.
Did
we're
you
a weird
see that
time
Project
bubble.
Veritas drop today?
No, I didn't.
No, they drop another Ruth bomb.
What did James
October surprise?
Some dude in Texas, in Colorado, who's like, I don't know. It's very difficult to pin him down on what he believes. He just wants to tear everything down. Talking about guillotine.
Like a Joker kind of guy? Was this?
Kinda.
Like a twisted Joker?
Twisted Joker. Yeah, like a political Joker.
Yeah, okay.
He's like an accelerationist.
Just wants to see the world burn kind of guy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but he wants to like, what do you say? He said he wanted to get guillotines out and just threaten billionaires with being beheaded in the streets. Go in Versailles. Okay. He said go in Versailles on him. He also said
he wants to be an active part of it.
Round up.
Who said
all
that like a month ago? We should KLL them in Minecraft.
I'm pretty sure we say that like weekly on a show.
He wants to round up all the billionaires and put them on an island and with cameras on pay per view to watch them like fend for them, like Lord of the Flies situation.
Oh, that would be awesome.
It was very conflicting to listen to him because some of them like, yeah, that's not a bad idea. I'm like, no, dude, that's too far.
I know it is too far. I'm totally.
Yeah, I don't
kidding.
Know if I'd be able to watch billionaires
maybe
murder each other.
That's
on
why
island.
Jeff Bezos is getting so jacked is because he actually anticipates that's going to happen to him.
He's
and
ready
he's
for the battle
gonna
royale
clean,
situation. Yeah, that's
just
going to
clean up on the battlefield.
Probably.
Yeah. If we take all their money and fund a stimulus for to stay at home for COVID again, right? We just pass that out amongst us and watch them. I can do that. I'll buy TV for that.
Oh, see, James was just in the waiting room. And I didn't even notice it. And I just texted him.
Did he leave? See?
No, he's coming. He's joining now.
You said come.
He's coming right now.
He did. It's true.
Yeah.
See, only the truest of facts. He really did
James
say no.
Cruz.
James Cruz. Oh, he's on the
James
PC.
James Cruz.
Yeah, hell yeah. What's up, man?
Hey, guys.
You made
just,
it.
Dude, it was that Windows update. I had no clue, man. I chilling, and all of a sudden.
Yep. You're fucked.
Whatever.
Fuck. Bill Gates is messing with you.
Yeah, man. 60.
Bill Gates would be the first to lose on that island. By the
yes.
Way. Scrawny little fucking wearing a fucking
sweater
vest bitch.
It's only take one hand to strangle him.
Yeah, man.
You know what Bill Gates definitely couldn't do is kill a mountain lion. I could guarantee that.
that was crazy. That video of that dude on that trail with the mountain lion coming. That had to be mama or something, right?
Yeah, she had four cubs.
No doubt.
Rock at it. Dude,
yeah.
Jesus.
All you had to do was charge that thing like you wanted to wear its fur and skin. As a coat.
She was in protection mode, though. I wouldn't have charged
no
her.
Way,
you just had
dude.
To be an alpha. You just had
this
to be an
alpha
chat alpha, about it.
Alpha bitch.
This is why you always carry a gun when hiking.
Oh, yeah.
I love that
he
the guy.
He couldn't have shot her, though.
No way.
She had four babies.
Yeah.
Coming at you.
My favorite part of that video was how he does like a YouTube sign off too. Like he was commenting about the whole situation after it happened. So it's like, it just gives like a weird vibe to that whole video.
Sure to like and subscribe.
Like, hey, Jake here. I'm getting murdered by a cougar. And so make sure to smash that like button because I'm going to die.
James Cruz.
Whoops.
Never let a good crisis clicks. Go to waste.
Never.
Yeah.
It's just the same thing as that dude that jumps on sharp objects all the times and says,
"Are we talking about Superhuman?"
Yeah.
That guy's awesome. Whoop whoop. That's it for the juggalos.
Oh yeah, this is a.
This is for the juggalos and the juggalettes. This is Superhuman, and this is for all the juggalos and juggalettes. I am going to jump off this boy into this pile of Legos and light bulbs.
Yeah.
Then he takes off his shirt and does a little twist, and he's like,
"Hell yeah!"
And he's on his trampoline sometimes a lot. Yeah. Fuck this shit. And then just jumps and eats it every time.
Fucking piles through whatever the fuck it is.
They always cut the video while he's dying.
Fucking halogens.
Yeah, everyone screenshots it, and they're just like, "Look at his back." Every Sunday, he posts a new one.
He heals and he goes again.
You want to talk about still like a competitive keeping eater. The early
he heals with the Regeneron.
Backyard.
Screws and Mistakes now brought to you by Regeneron.
Regeneron. You could say it like in all these different.
Has anybody heard of Regeneron
so
before?
Cool.
But before Trump even got it, did anybody even hear of Regeneron? Is that the first?
Yeah, that's what the Transformers were hunting down, wasn't it?
I think it was. Yes. I'm pretty sure it was.
Practically.
Yeah.
Well, that was the Power Rangers.
You can't spell Regeneron without Energon.
Energon, yeah.
They said he was on two experimental drugs, right? I guess this is one of them. Yes. Yes. Man. Just experiment on our president.
The other one's it's called Black.
Sounded legit to me.
Yeah. He's got this bottle that's got black goo in it.
It's an experimental drug that was released on September 29th.
Mm.
Wow.
Damn, that's pretty fresh and new.
I just found out that the most kids are born on September 9th. It's like the most, like every, like that has the most births of like every year. I don't know. It's always like September 9th. Everyone's fucking in the winter. Right?
I think I know a couple of people that were born on September 9th.
Crazy.
That's funny.
Those are New Year's Eve births then.
Right, or New Year's, right, okay, yeah. I mean,
that's math.
Just do the math, yeah. So that was pretty weird.
Gonna have to run some gamotrinator on that first.
At least a gamotrinator.
At least a gamotrinator. Maybe several other ones too, but, you know, until we get the correct results.
I want to say I'm so proud of you guys for actually pronouncing gamotria correctly.
Mm. Why? Hey,
I mean, it's not hard.
Gematria? Is that what
it's not? John. That's not just a.
Yeah.
Jerry, you're the one that taught us.
I know. I'm just proud of you. It brings a tear to my eye.
That's the one. Oh, that's the one thing on top of the 50 others that I just mush out of my mouth every single day. Just mispronounce.
So trying to get one. Trying to fucking red pill those Costco employees.
God.
No, there's no.
It's a gematria of sirloin.
Gematria.
Reduce the numbers of the price of the steak.
Colts code.
See what it comes up to.
I still can't figure it out. It's definitely it's the template for the New World Order that's going to be happening, 100%.
What is
I just
worst
Costco.
New World Order ever, by the
I'm
way.
Just, I'm feeling it out. It's all about, you know, this everything, this one-stop shop location where you could get everything you could possibly need in this one building, and like it's a weird thing. It's a weird environment, and I'm still it's almost like it's one of these things where I'm waiting for the demons to show underneath, because everybody's just like it's almost too good. It's weird. Like it's just really fucking weird.
Right.
Like I don't trust it. I'm waiting for something weird to happen.
You've just been living in the country too long.
That could it could be it.
You don't just, trust the city slickers yet.
I mean, but I mean, this part of Jersey isn't really city though, so it's
Jersey or Philly.
I'm working in Jersey right now. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but yeah, it's
Where what's the biggest city near
Oh, Cherry Hill. Cherry Hill is huge. Okay. That's where
I used to work in Edison.
Don't know where that is.
I don't either.
I don't fucking know. Yeah.
There's no concept of things around here. But
things. What things?
What is space anyway?
Space. I watched. What did I watch?
Distance. What the
dude,
fuck?
Elon Musk came out and said that he saw no evidence of aliens on Twitter. He's saying it's that's all bullshit. Chill. Yeah.
I watched Edison. Go ahead.
Edison is an hour north of you. So.
Oh, okay.
Sounds about right. I watched this kick-ass like movie. You remember the Battlestar Galactica? That chick that played Starbuck, like she's the blonde-haired girl. Like she's in a bunch of different TV shows also, but
actually, this is from the newer one, yeah.
Yeah, it's from the newer Battlestar.
I can't think of her name, but yeah, I know.
She's been in a lot of stuff. I enjoy her. Like, but she actually did a sci-fi Netflix series last year. It's all right, but she
Hera
did this
Thrace is her name.
So she did this flick and it's on Amazon Prime right now, and it's called Origins Unknown. It's fucking sweet. It's like this cube that shows up on Mars. Is it bad? I don't know. I thought it's pretty like it's pretty like slow, but like it's her and an AI like going at it, basically. Not like love triangle, but like going at it as in like at each other, you know, like these decisions that are made and stuff. And the year is like 2036, I think it is the time frame they're in. And they had one point they sent the first manned mission and it fucking like crashed and burned the second they got there. Everything was working perfect, and then the whole story begins after that, and like what happened and why and all this cool crazy shit. And it involves a black monolith on Mars. It's fucking awesome.
No symbology there, eh?
It's a cube. It's pretty cool. It's pretty neat. It does like different things, and there's lots of cool like stuff we're into that's all in it.
Her name's actually Katie Sackhoff. Kara Thrace is her Battlestar Galactica name.
Okay. Oh, that's what it was. Yeah, Kara Thrace. But her nickname was Starbuck. I remember.
Was she in Nexium? She looks like she was in Nexium.
She should be. She's got the tattoos for it. No, the branding. Sorry.
Yeah.
Let's see what else. I don't know. I watched this crazy one today. This Russian one called Invasion.
Like, any good?
Dude, it was for like a dubbed Russian movie is okay.
Did you watch that?
I'm the king of dubs, so I don't know.
Did you watch a coma movie?
No,
that was a dubbed Russian movie.
No, yeah. So this one involves a lot of CGI, but it's phenomenal. Like, I've never seen some of the CGI they've done in this. It's fucking awesome. And it's cool because they call in the military and stuff. But guess what? It's not U.S. military, like, surplus. It's Russian surplus. So it's like the MiG-29. It's like all the cool Russian shit instead of, like, the U.S. military stuff. They use all different shit. But there's lots of cool sci-fi. It's fucking crazy. It's 2 hours and 15 minutes long. I couldn't believe it. All this cool shit was happening, and I look at the time left. There's 50 minutes left. I'm like, what the fuck?
Damn.
What else do they do in this thing? But it's fucking cool, man. These aliens use water, and then they fucking do crazy shit with water. It's fucking awesome. Yeah. So, and Earth has a lot of water on it.
I think is that the one that was Annihilation 2 Invasion?
Yeah, something like that. Yeah. Yeah, it was the second one, I guess.
You know what I saw half of today was Capricorn 1. Have you guys ever seen that movie?
It sounds familiar, but I don't think I've seen it.
It's an old movie from like the late 70s, early 80s. Yeah. James Brolin, Sam somebody or other, and OJ Simpson are astronauts on their way to Mars. And this dude comes and gets them out of the capsule right before takeoff and then flies them 2 hours away to a warehouse where they're going to simulate the Mars landing.
What? Oh, shit.
Wow.
So, in other words, it's a documentary.
Yeah, it's a documentary. Exactly. Yes. It definitely shows how it's possible to do it, you know? Yeah, Capricorn One is awesome. Booty Rooter. They even say one of the lines in it right away is, funny thing happened on the way to Mars.
On the way to Mars, yeah. So, I don't know.
That O.J. Simpson's got some range, yo, don't he?
No, he's got like two lines in the whole movie. What the hell are we supposed to be doing? Like,
hey, you know, he murders it. Though.
Do you remember? Remember the character Stork in Animal House?
Oh,
the guy they thought was retarded. He had like one line. He goes, "What the hell are we supposed to do?" That guy, like near the end. Remember that guy? Mm-hmm. He wrote. He was one of the writers of Animal House.
Animal House was like right on the edge of the beginning of crazy shit. Probably I would have seen when I was a kid. Like, I don't think I really ever saw it, you know, like it, that, because it just age wise, like, I don't know, like it, I just kind of missed Animal House a lot. I don't think I even really to this day have seen all of it, like in one sitting. Like, I just never got into that when I was younger. I don't know. I think I missed it.
That's kind of the end of National Lampoon. They kind of went their way separate ways after that.
And I mean, Animal House. Yeah, I think that was one of those, and then all the other stuff came out after that. And that's all the shit I've saw. Like, Animal House must have come out in the early 80s. I don't know what year exactly, but 78. See, I was born in 78. That's why, like, it's not in my wheelhouse, right?
Of course you were. It was a sign. Animal House and James Cruise. They were born at the same time.
It was funny. It was. Dude, I was listening back and I heard you were talking about when you saw Van Halen and it was in 78.
Yeah.
And that was funny that this comes up and we're talking and it happens to be in 78. Like, yeah. We're going to come up with the coolest 78 thing we could find. Everywhere.
Right? Where's Ed Bell at? I know.
Yeah, 78 or bust, we'll call it. Yeah.
Yeah, I started having a kid year after you, James. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
My first one was 79. So
okay, yeah. Well, I mean, I don't know. Yeah, the kid front on my home life is fucking bananas right now. I tried doing a podcast on the couch with the little one last whatever.
Oh, Shonen Dump. Yeah.
Yeah. Yes. I actually listened back. It wasn't too bad, except at the end there was like crazy.
No, it wasn't bad at all.
Way too loud. Yeah, it was crazy loud. It was like. And but yeah,
she had a few outbursts. She had a it was her first
it was fun. It was tough to do. I was laughing the entire time. I had a gay old time, no doubt about it.
Yeah,
I can't wait to do it again. I'm obviously, hopefully,
shonendump.com
baby side
Samurai X. Which for anybody who listens to that,
stand to be real.
You need to address this. Apparently, the the author of Samurai X, the guy who created it. Like a couple of years ago,
the creator of Rurouni Kenshin.
Yeah.
Well, it's the same thing. Well,
it is. I mean, it's the manga.
It's the same character, and
yes,
yeah, he got rolled up for CP. So yeah, I mean,
CP rolled up.
CWS is a,
I mean, he couldn't just fucking survive within the very lax Japanese federal laws.
Extremely lax.
I mean, they don't. Come on.
The most lax laws.
You had to be greedy. You had to be greedy, you piece of shit. So we didn't address that.
I mean, Cruising with Steak is an anti-pedophilia podcast, but we actually haven't necessarily claimed that for ShonenDump.com. But we are now officially doing it for both podcasts.
Yes.
It definitely is a thing.
Yep.
Yeah. Damn.
And we but you bring, know,
separate,
bring
the, separate the art for the artist. Speaking of, did anybody, I mean, Happy Happy Joy Joy documentary with
I watched most of it.
That thing was so fucking good. Well, I was I was shocked because I knew about like all the scandals that John Kay had.
Unreal.
And then, like, to see him to see him like in there at the beginning, I was like, what the fuck? I'm like, they're just not even to talk about this. And then towards the end, they're like, okay, so John, you're dating, like, you groomed all these girls and shit. And it was just like, oh man, like they went into it. But yeah, that was fucked up. But that was an awesome documentary. That was really good.
He had all those people working there for him. Steady. Yeah, that's crazy.
Yeah,
and they're all super young chicks. Right? Yeah,
yeah. He kept. Yeah, he did some fucked up stuff. But that's John Kay. But you know, that's what gets you the, I hate to say it, but that's what gets you the best art, is you need some fucking weird motherfucker that's just not, their brain is not wired like everybody else's. And then they make just fucked up shit that you enjoy. You gotta separate the art from the artist.
Speaking of crazy individuals, any updates on Mr. McAfee? I thought he got like held up in Spain or something.
Yeah, he apparently got rolled up in Spain. And his Twitter feed is, it seems like people are posting from it, like letters he's writing from jail, like, because it seems like his writing, but it's like a copy-pasted text. So that's basically the most you get. Yeah, he's probably just, he's going to be, I don't know. See,
it's kind of hard to tell.
Yeah, it's a weird thing. Because he boasts a lot, and he also fakes a lot of shit, so who even knows what's real? He's all about sending disinformation about himself out there, so is he even arrested? Do we even know that?
Yeah.
Or did he just have to fuck it?
It probably isn't the same part of the world anyway. Like,
Yes, I don't know.
And he's on the opposite side of the bowl.
McAfee. Jesus, well, this guy's a maniac.
Q's been pretty quiet too, so you know, I'm not saying anything, but I haven't seen Q and McAfee in the same room together.
No, that is true. You know,
to be fair, we haven't seen Q and Chang in the same room either.
Oh damn. God damn. I have seen Chang and Gordon Ramsay in the same room together.
I don't know about Q stuff, but the reality is that's a fact. We the people woken up.
Yeah.
We have. Yeah, Q, I mean we could come on guys. I mean that's
when was the last Q drop anyway? We need that guy.
No, yes, that guy is vacation.
Or if a non-coon's listening, he'll usually have some kind of chamber.
Like it's happening.
Chamber.
Something. Something, just some sort of purple screenshot that I'll see for 4chan posted. Just give me that purple background.
I know it.
Yeah. Man. I mean, the Chans is the ultimate source of just bullshit. It's almost like I feel, I don't know, man. Just growing up on the internet, it's basically like I have the mentality of everything that I see on here is bullshit anyway. Like, everything on the internet's bullshit. You should just take that. So it's like now when you see everybody believing and trusting so hard shit that they see on the internet, it's like, where were you guys? Hard. What? Like, did you, I don't know. There needs to be some sort of...
Did you miss the 90s?
That's what has to happen. There needs to be, I don't know, like some sort of documentary about internet culture from 1990 to like 2020, just 30 years.
At least.
There's been like early internet culture, I think would shock a lot of people now. It's fucking
hard lessons learned. Hard lessons learned.
I don't know, like trolls have existed forever. And now it's like people think the internet's this sacred place where everybody has to be on the up and up. And I don't know. It's weird.
Yeah.
It's a weird thing. It's not society. Social media is like, not like society, and you should not apply the same rules to the internet that you do in real life. It's crazy.
Yeah, cancel, I mean, culture, maybe anyway. Maybe you have to have trolls to make the internet work. Who knows?
I mean, it is. Maybe. But we don't know. I mean, Cruising with Steak has been around for over 3 years. What the fuck?
Yeah. Whatever this is evolving to, it's obviously not a good way for it to evolve, no matter what.
No, like, it's no positive influence on the internet. Sure it is.
I don't know if like early internet culture necessarily did either, but it wasn't quite as insane. It was this much smaller subsection of people, right?
True.
Like, Your mom wasn't on early internet experiencing like IRC chats or some shit like that.
No,
like,
no, she, you know what I mean? Like, use that for
but she anything. But she has a Facebook profile.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, to my knowledge, nobody ever sent my mother to Goatsy.
Yes.
To my knowledge,
that you know of.
Just too scarred to talk about it.
Do you ever just have one of those nights where you came home and she just looked a little off and just like pissed and confused? Maybe it was just because
somebody sent me a hidden link in AIM to Tub Girl. It just just fucked up.
Yep. But no, yeah, I mean, nobody's that probably wasn't good either, but it was such, it was like less than 1% of people. Like there was very few people relative to how many people are on it now. Yeah. I remember when YouTube was a thing, like when it was first a thing, and seeing like, even up until like the mid 2000s being like, oh my God, this has 20 million views on YouTube. That's insane. Like how could anything have 20 million people watch this video? And like within a couple of days, music videos have like hundreds of millions of views. I mean, of course it's all just bought and sold bullshit. I know it's not all real traffic, and I don't know if it was back then either, but yeah.
That's another
thing. The scale of everything is so much bigger.
How much of this circle jerky, you know, of just fake traffic, fake clicks, the internet advertising before that bubble just bursts? Because it's so much of that shit is generated by not humans. Nobody that's going to actually buy any content.
As long as people at the highest levels are making money off of it, I don't really see it going anywhere. Like, I don't know why they would make a big deal out of it. Like, it's all just fake anyway. Why not just make money off of that shit too? You know what I mean? Like, you're right. It literally only goes away if people just like pay attention to it. Like, it'd be super easy to get rid of, but it won't happen.
So I just, I have YouTube Red, so I don't get any ads. And earlier, Lady Boshi was on her YouTube using it. And dude, every single ad is a Biden ad. Like every single YouTube ad is a Biden ad. It's insane. Like over and over. Like, what is going on right now? I'm like, why is this happening again? Just relentless.
And Trump just plays his gaffes for a minute and a half. That's his ad, is just Biden stuttering through a minute and a half of.
Yeah, but it's edited together like a horror movie trailer.
Yeah, I mean I don't really get advertised too much, so it's like really all I have is Twitter, and Trump's Twitter feed is all I need to know to know that he's going to be president again. Like he's just too perfect.
The way to get around that is when you get a Twitter ad, just block it.
Oh yeah, I have. So that's all my blocked accounts are just promoted tweets, every single one. And I think Biden actually might be blocked because he was on a promoted tweet for a while.
I blocked
like, the
Biden
fuck is going
ago.
On?
Because he just spews lies.
Oh yeah.
Oh, he's a liar. No, thank yeah. So different from these other non-lying politicians.
Yeah, all these other.
He's especially liarful.
Oh,
he's
okay.
A special kind of prevaricator.
Prevaricator, I like that.
Why the hell would I take a test?
What are you taking?
Come on, man.
Oh, man.
I've been making clips right now. That's what I've been doing.
Yesterday he said, what did he say?
Why the hell would I take a test?
He said he was good.
Running for Senate.
Yes, he was running for Senate. He said he couldn't remember Mitt Romney's name.
What are we talking about? Come on.
Sorry.
Fucked up what state he was in, too. Again.
Damn.
I see. And you know what, Jerry? I saw all of that in one Trump tweet. So, I mean, really, that's why Trump's
the one I retweeted. Or?
I don't. Well, I mean, I follow him, so it's possible. But yeah, it is. It's like all you have to do is follow Trump and you know everything that the news is going to talk about. You know everything that's going on. And then
did you watch it? Did you see his rally last night?
No.
He's like, I'm immune. He's going on. I'm immune. I'm immune. I could come down and give everybody a kiss.
God damn, I want some Regeneron so bad.
Dude, I can't wait to get on that. So he's going to make it free for everyone. Could you imagine a drug called Regeneron being free to everyone?
He's been high as fuck for days now, just floating. I love it. Just give it to me.
Did you see him dancing?
It wasn't technically a dance.
Dude, he was cutting a rug. He's cutting a rug. He wasn't dancing.
He was skiing. He was air wanking. Yeah. Like if you
air wanking, yeah.
Just jerking two guys off. He was pumping.
Was that joke? The guy that he wakes up, he's like, yeah, I was dreaming I was skiing. Yeah.
Old man twerking, that's all.
Yeah.
Damn.
Old man twerking.
Yesterday was Columbus Day.
It's Indigenous Peoples Day.
Yeah, they had school off at the Catholic school.
Columbus was
right next to me here. Yeah, and Friday they had a 4-day party weekend. Yeah,
the banks were closed.
Yeah,
yep.
James, it was like Thanksgiving.
Are
up
your
in
kids going to school, James? James,
what?
He's stuck in a fucking.
Yeah.
Are your kids in school?
Are your kids in school?
No, they're at home. They're at home.
Oh, they're homeschooled.
They're still
are
home.
Your schools yeah. open? Or
yeah, they're open. And but it's funny, dude. Like, they'll put out the reports of like certain child or teachers, whatever, in this particular class came down with Corona and they're in quarantine. You know, like they'll put out these little reports and shit. It's weird. They're like police reports, kind of. You know, they give like vague info. Like, they won't say if it's a kid or if it was a teacher, but you know, everybody in this spot is gone. And then, but now I guess like last weekend, my wife was telling me that there was apparently somebody had this huge fucking party, like, and a bunch of fucking people got it. Yeah, like they're talking about like closing down the school and just quote unquote saying it's for like national like testing week or whatever.
How do they know that a bunch of people from that party got it though?
I guess like even the teachers were there. It was kind of one of those parties.
My point is, did
they all get tested?
Yeah. What happened? To find out.
How do you beat a virus? Is you have a big party and let a lot of people get it, and let's pass it around a little bit and be done with this shit. Let's not carry on for another 2 years.
Oh, I was watching videos from fucking like Stockholm just for a while. It's so beautiful. I'm so jealous. Like they're all. It's completely normal.
They don't care.
They're just doing it. Like, well, because
I watched that too. That girl, she's like, look at the train station.
Yeah, dude. Nobody has masks. It looks like fucking pre-COVID world over there. It's beautiful. Yeah.
I got refused a pancake this weekend.
God damn it, Nikki. Like, this is pancake.
Of all the places I went in, that's what I'm saying. Every one of them had mask required on the door, you know. And every place I went in said nothing except the Pancake Palace. And she was insistent on me putting this mask on outside at the stand, walking 7 feet in there to my table,
Karen,
and taking
with the power
it off
trip.
And put it back on when I go to the bathroom or stand up from my table. But as long as I sat at my table, I was cool.
No, because there's bubbles around the tables that don't allow the virus to get in.
We can't get you when you're sitting down.
Right, Nikki, you're a fucking science denier, aren't you?
Yes, I am. I am 100%. I walked in the hot mineral bath was required in the lobby. But I walked through. They didn't care. So, I went in there and got my nostrils bleached out by 102 degree water for about 25, 30 minutes. I felt like I was pretty good.
What's going on, James?
I'm just saving. Oh, it's playing.
Every single time.
Oh, my God.
I'm riffing with him, actually. Me and Joe's got the same. We got the same kind of meter, you know?
Yeah. It's playing. It's great. Okay.
My draw is slow enough to keep up with him. Yeah.
I'm doing editing on the fly, and it's coming across the airwaves. Awesome. God. Yeah. My bad, dude. I forgot to hit mute.
Oh, it's fine. It's cool.
Did you know that there's no actual, like, nobody has officially named a portrait of Christopher Columbus? So nobody actually really knows what he looks like. It's literally just like, there's been no portrait attributed to. It's
probably a giant.
Is that true?
Christopher Columbus. Yeah. Try to find one. Just look it up. Prison Planet.
The one I've always seen of him, though, he's given the Mason symbol with his hand, and he's
everyone does that in the old pictures,
right?
The hidden hand.
Yeah. What about this Masons. One that I can't?
Is it just going to be Is it just going to be a picture of or is it actually a portrait of him was alive?
It's the one I remember. I can't share a screen.
Yes, you can now, Jer.
Just put it in the chat.
Fuck that.
Yeah, fuck that shit.
Oh yeah, there we go. There you go. There's the Mason symbol right there. See, right, Bill?
That's the Star Trek thing.
Is that really him?
No, you
got to
spread the middle two fingers.
Yeah, come on. Live long and
prosper. Come on. That's an M there.
You know about Vulcans.
That says Cristobal Colon. Who is that? That's
Christopher Columbus's real name.
Okay. So now we're just making up names for him too.
I'm not making it up. It's
wow.
I think what really just happened is Flavortown got debunked instantly on it.
I don't think so.
Hundreds of them.
I'm pretty sure you did. That's a portrait of Christopher Columbus right there.
I don't see it. I don't know who that is.
Maybe if you said photograph. Photograph? I'd believe you.
That is true. Not a single photograph, Christopher. It would have taken in 1492. It would have taken
7 years.
No. Yeah. 7 years back in 1492.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Hey, dude, they got to stand still. It takes all that time for all the light to capture the whole picture.
Anyway, Christopher Columbus.
Nicky can back me up on that.
Oh yeah, we're getting a photo like it's 1499.
No, I don't know. Yeah. Just show me a battle.
Look, it says portrait of a man said to be Christopher Columbus. They won't even say that.
Oh, that is true. Damn.
Look at that. Look at that.
I don't buy it then. Yes.
Portrait of a man said to be Christopher Columbus. Get that shit out of here.
It's a guess. It's not definitive.
They literally just found a picture of a guy and said it might have been. Yeah, look. Nobody knows what he looks like.
Well, this was after he transitioned to a woman.
Lotto? Didn't they like find his passport on the beach or something afterwards?
They found the black box afterwards.
I don't think anybody knows what he looked like. I think you might be right.
Who cares what he looked like?
That one that you posted looks like
he's
Sven.
Not real.
Sven's. I don't know what Sven looks like.
I think you know exactly what Sven looks like.
I don't. I never thought about it. To be honest, I never actually thought about what he would look like.
Damn. But I will find a picture. I think we need some AI bot. What you need to do is somehow run all that text, all of Sven's emails, I need to run those through some sort of generator that could generate a personality. A personality text. Mm-hmm. It's probably something like that.
There's also another fun fact that says that Christopher Columbus has been reburied in many different places around the world. Because for some reason, that's really important.
Yeah, I mean, always.
Fucking Christopher Columbus is Dracula.
Yeah, please, just dig up my body and bury it somewhere else. Just once every 10 years.
Why would he need to be reburied unless he... That was... I don't know if, like... some of the original vampire myths, like, parts of their power came from where they were buried.
What are we talking about?
And those, if you reburied them in different parts of the world, maybe he would gather more power.
Vampire like lore.
Okay. Something like that? I don't know.
Damn.
We might have to make this into a comic book or some shit.
Maybe.
Okay, so...
The mighty Christopher Columbus?
Yeah, Christopher Columbus, vampire conqueror.
It says in this very, very legitimate looking WordPress article that I found that... when Christopher Columbus died, he died in a plane. They buried him in like some plain ass cemetery.
Plane crash. Oh.
And he got reburied in 1509 in the city of Seville. Stayed there for 30 years. Then they built a cathedral, and the Spanish government was like, actually, let's go ahead and put Christopher Columbus's bones in this cathedral. So they took those out and put them in there. And there his body was for another 250 years.
Dar he lay.
Spain turned over. Then he went to Cuba. So they took him in Cuba after Spain lost a war to France. So, in 1877, a group of workers doing some remodeling in the Santo Domingo Cathedral uncovered a large lead box buried behind the altar that was not supposed to be there. It bore the inscription. This sounds like a National Treasure movie.
I know. I'm excited. I'm like,
the illustrious
right now,
and distinguished man, Don Colon, Admiral of the Oceans. Although Christopher Columbus's son Diego, who was also been buried in the cathedral, had also inherited the title Admiral of the Oceans, the Dominican government, perhaps not surprisingly, concluded that the bones were those of Christopher himself. The Spanish authorities in Cuba declared that they had the real Christopher Columbus skeleton and also had Diego's remains as well. So for 150 years, this cathedral and these Cuban people argued that they had Christopher Columbus's bones. Nice. So apparently Christopher Columbus's bones is the most important thing in history between 1492 and, I guess,
Flavortown?
The 1900s.
I think they put them in the Ark of the Covenant and they're guarded in Ethiopia now.
That's probably true. I mean, why go through, what is this story? He didn't even discover America. And they're treating him like he's just like this demigod. Was he a longhead?
Yeah. Why do we have Columbus Day?
Was he a lizard?
What is all this? Yeah. This Columbus worship.
He must have been at least some sort of high priest.
The way that they're treating his bones, it seems like they're treating him like he's like it's some fucking like mystical,
very reverential.
Like King fucking.
Yeah. Let's talk about the Jews here.
There it is.
Mm hmm. that's exactly what happened.
Was Miami. Christopher Columbus
the Jews
a Jew?
Got him.
Dude,
it's reported that he was a Jew.
Ooh. Yeah.
Oh, it all makes sense.
Oh, wait, I got one right here.
Columbus
wait, I got it. Posting it in the chats now. Timesofisrael.com. Christopher Columbus, the hidden Jew.
There you go.
And it's the same portrait of somebody who might be Christopher Columbus. Imagine thinking history
come
is real,
on,
though.
Man.
Imagine.
Come on, man. How many push-ups you want to do here, pal? Oh, come on, man.
Why the hell would I take a test?
2020 and Trump's sick memes like this on Twitter.
What is he doing?
My God.
Come on, man.
So the latest conspiracy is that Biden's going to drop dead. Like, he's going to drop out of the race because he's going to drop dead.
Oh, my God. I can imagine.
Right.
Yeah.
Biden for
is that an actual
president?
Tweet?
That's an actual tweet.
That's
an actual tweet.
That's killer. Yeah.
Little
nursing home action with great great grandma.
He is just straight posting memes now. Like he's just a shit poster. 100%.
Yeah, I'm gonna post a shit meme I made, or not even a meme. I made some art today. I'll post that again because it's fun.
Oh man, trust. That's some good trust. Yeah, oh man, yeah. Pre-beard Grimstake.
That's old school.
So months.
That was the old Fonzie one. I remember like trying to come up with. I remember trying to make something with that. What was that shoe phone shark jump? Or yeah, right.
What was that?
The name of the, was that the name of the episode? I think
shoe phone. Yeah, all the arts. For it's in the art.
Channel. Yeah, you had the. Yeah, I know. I just stopped. Thank God somebody else started making art.
You fucking
nuts.
Gave up like a loser. I gave up. So someone else had to do it.
I know. I had cool. to, dude. I did it for like 2 years. I'm like, oh my God.
And I didn't have any kind of fancy iPhone GIF maker either.
Yeah, yeah. It's I use a few apps to do it. But yeah, it worked out pretty good.
I use a real computer. That's why my art looks so much better.
Yeah, I guarantee it. I mean, someday down here, it's going to be beautiful. Can't wait. But I got like 5 other projects before I get to this one.
Although this week was kind of shitty.
We all had grand ams. Yeah. Is that the one?
I wanted to find like a car show with all grand ams, and I couldn't find that show.
Yeah, that'd be the worst car show ever.
That would be insane. Yeah.
I did get a strike on episode 111.
Yeah, what happened with that? Pardon my French tickler?
Whoa.
Yes, they struck down my thumbnail. They said it was went against community guidelines.
Oh, man.
So fucking
for
gay.
What? It doesn't even make any sense.
Didn't say. Probably because it got.
Well, that means that the bots are going visual now, and they'll interpret images. Apparently,
let's get visual.
True.
Shoe phone shark jump right here.
I wanna get visual. Yeah. Visual.
Right there.
It's wild. It's
the Shaq phone, dude. The Shaq shoe. Oh man. It's like a size 40.
Is that a fucking shoe phone?
Yeah, is that a fucking chew phone? Yeah, the phone.
Sharks going nom 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 nom.
Yeah, man. Ugh.
Good times.
Yeah, I mean the word trust is flying around constantly in these chats. I don't know what it means to you guys, but to me, I don't know.
trust us. We're throwing it around as a joke.
I understand. Yeah, I was just seeing what it means to you guys. I don't know.
What trust means to me?
Yeah.
Man.
Like, what will give you, like, your trust, you know, like that, yeah, that's what I guess I'm asking. Like,
well, not, I have no trust in the, any politics or U.S. government. Like, that's yeah, for sure. None of the trust lies there.
Yeah, trust.
I trust you guys.
Exactly.
Right.
I don't trust anything else.
That's what
else.
I mean. Like, yeah.
Zoom.
Nothing
world.
Else.
We've developed a community of sorts, right? So, yeah, I think we trust each other in that mm-hmm. aspect. And that's what I mean. Like, yeah, and all these other things are like, what does it take to, in your, even like walking around, you know, like, is it someone that smiles at you? I would probably trust that person, or, you know, like, or is it not the, you know, the person that looks away and looks down at the ground, you know, like, what the fuck, you know, like, I ain't, yeah, like, it's so weird. I get, and at the same time, you don't want to judge a book by its cover, but, you know,
you don't want to be totally untrusting of people.
Yeah, and these speaking weird of, times, these times are trust. So wacky. Like, what about the person begging for change? But dude, they could like stab you or something.
I've given $10 away in the last 3 days.
Yeah. I gave some guy change the other day too.
Yeah,
man, and they trust you now. It's awesome.
Speaking of trust, so the other day, me and Lady Boshi, we were walking down to the liquor store, and there was, there's been this dude, he lives down the street, he's this black dude, he's fucking super friendly, he's always talking, just always reeks of weed. And like, we walk by, we're like, damn, it smells good here. He's like, oh, hell yeah, you know, he's talking and
yeah,
stuff.
Man.
And then the other night, we walk by, and you know, we're like, hey, how's it going? And he, you know, talking, and then on our way back, he's like, hey, come here. And we like, go over there, and he gives us this fucking, this like 2 gram blunt in this fucking vial. He's like, here. He's like, you guys smoke this, like, let me know what you think of it. And it was like, it was the smoothest fucking smoke. Like, it was amazing. It was just incredible. It was like wet, wrapped up in keef and shit.
Yeah.
And it was, it, dude,
oh
it was
my god,
so fucking wild.
Oh my god,
it was amazing blunt. But that was just like, that's one of these kindness of strangers kind of things. You know, it's like, because
yes,
you know, we don't know. We just see him, you know, walking by, passing, just small talk, say hi. And then
now another pothead.
Another
pothead's not going to do that.
Exactly.
Yeah.
That is exactly it, dude.
And that's
why people are the best people.
Guy.
Like, yeah, dude, yes. Weed people are great.
There's a lot of talk about Southern hospitality, but I think Northern hospitality doesn't get as much of a good rep as it should.
Hey, thanks, dude.
Except in New York, they're assholes up there.
Well, I've never been to New York.
I've only heard a different animal.
Shit,
those cities.
I do gotta say, honestly, I've only heard bad shit.
I've been in way normal, easy parts and going new parts of New York. It's just New York City. You want to say that has been? Well, I guess
that's what I'm talking
some
about.
Of the state. I mean, the whole state has some crazy laws. I know that, like liquor laws, cigarette laws, a pack of smokes is like $10 in New York and shit. Like,
I think it's
crazy
like
stuff.
Now.
Yeah, it's probably way more now. Ooh. I mean, that was,
well,
I remember.
Now I get a smoke one.
Yeah, dude, I remember, like, I can imagine being a smoker up in those areas. Yeah, they just hiked the price up, man, and like some people are forced out of it. Yeah, it's, or they start rolling their own. I know a lot of us peeps here. A lot of people that listen roll their own things, all kinds of things, lots of tobacco. People in the chats will just start spitting it all out. They'll be putting fucking all their different recipes and scenarios for the perfect like cigarette, or you know, or the perfect blunt. You know, it's great, and. It's even better when Felix shows up, because I want to hear some sweet jabs.
Hi.
Is he here? Oh, he's here.
Felix is here.
Felix.
Hey, guys.
Felix is here.
Hey.
To nine.
How you doing?
Can I share a unique memory that's unique to me?
Yeah,
you
should
play
that
jingle.
Yeah, we should do that for
sure.
Because it's so good. That's
my favorite
one.
One
of the best ones, yeah. Remember jingles? We gotta throw these out again. We gotta start.
Oh, yeah, we got
have
tech news segment after all this, too. Flavortown.
Oh, we should.
Share a memory that's unique to you. A memory worth retelling. And don't be afraid of being judged. Cause cruising with steak is a designated safe space.
Hey, take it away.
What's that?
So I've been going to the cemetery with my son, and there are these giant dirt hills that they had. I'm pretty.
Are you doing rubbings of gravestones?
No, just kind of. There's these giant dirt hills, and I just let them climb them. I would just put them in just sloppy clothes.
Cool.
And just let them go nuts. And I think they're it's from when people empty like potted plants from their graves, and they use it for other things, for probably like burying people.
Found a hill.
Okay.
So there's just in the cemetery, there's three cemetery different types of dirt. There's like dusty dirt.
Yeah.
And there's like real like chunky dirt.
Another
type of
dirt. There's dirt in the ground dirt. There's above ground dirt. Yeah. Then there's
just
the dusty
just different
dirt.
Levels.
Yeah.
Different levels.
Different stages of dirt. Yeah.
This could almost be the lead into a Pantera song.
Sounds fucking dirty, dude. Yeah.
But I'm pretty sure I found a couple of human remain bones.
No.
In it. Yeah.
No.
No
so
way.
So it's pretty.
No.
Pretty, I mean, it could have been just another animal or
how
something,
do you know?
But
yeah,
no.
What the bones look
but
like?
I held them in my hands, and it was just super profound. I was just thinking, this person like walked around on this
dude,
earth.
I would
and I'm
hope
holding their
so.
Bones.
No,
oh, it was weird.
Oh,
and I even
Felix.
Like, I even cracked it a little and like looked on the inside of it.
You're like, and I'm looking for some marrow.
Did you say licked on or looked on the inside?
Oh, dude.
I'm going to tell you, you were probably busting some possum bones open or something.
Probably.
Dude.
But who knows?
But it was pretty wild to see.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because most people that would be buried in a graveyard would be like in a casket.
Yeah, but there's
shit,
probably like there's probably like the $20 drop bones. Off or something, you know, like
oh yeah, the $20 drop.
Yeah, dude. Like the Potter's undercover shield. Like the yeah, or like
real old graves that they never put a headstone down
and it's true, yeah. Yeah, somebody so
they gotta make some more room. Oh shit, we dug
just
up
tosses
spot.
A body, tosses yeah. a body in the ground, yeah.
And there's many dead bodies in Earth here. Oh my God.
Yeah. There
the
is.
Thought just popped in my head. I'm like, I can't believe I'm holding someone's bones.
I don't want to be one of them. I can tell you that. I want to fire me up.
Hell
fire
yeah, man. I don't want to come back
fire
to life when
up.
Fucking Christ comes back
good,
and
dude.
Rises everybody.
I
Are
see the light.
Me?
I'm fucking taking my board and riding it. All
the talk about the rapture.
Yeah.
Reverse rapture.
Yeah, we talking rapture.
It won't be your old moldy zombie body, though. I mean,
oh, it will be.
Wearing a new, though. Brand new body.
I always heard, though, it's so
tempting.
You always hear, like, it's so tempting to go to the light, but you gotta avoid it. It's a trick or something, right? Like, I don't know.
They have these Skittles now that have, they're like Halloween ones, and a couple of them just randomly in the
glow
batch,
in the dark
like,
ones. No.
They're zombie flavored, so they're like real gross. Flavored
it says boogers yeah like some
no what was zombie flavored
yeah oh okay so the there's the whole pack that
it
way
tastes
or
like
is
a corpse.
It
tastes like a well maybe like a couple random ones my wife got them for our nephew.
You guys ever smelled burnt skin them. Before
oh yeah
oh god dude oh my god
yeah.
Okay, I mean, I just want to make sure because it's fucking nasty, dude.
I just want to verify, you know, make sure you all smelled that shit.
Yeah, because I mean,
I did a lot of arts and crafts.
Jesus,
skin tags.
Yeah, skin tags. Oh man,
I blue gun.
Nah, yeah, just I had my elbow burned off once from like some weird
Florence lava.
No, it was a
really bad rug burn.
It was a wart, actually. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, burn it off.
I've had a few of them. I had one on my toe once when I was a kid. I had one on my arm, one on the side of my finger, and yeah, like it's crazy. So like they go in, they fucking shoot it with Novocaine, and they take these scissors and they just start cutting around it in a circle. Then they take this thing that looks like it's like a ice cream scooper, but it's about an eighth inch, quarter inch wide, you know, a diameter.
Scalpel.
Yeah. And so they squeeze it. And so it's like I said, it's like an ice cream scoop, but then it goes like full cylinder. Yeah. They fucking grab that bitch and slice and they cut the whole thing out. Then they grab a soldering iron and just start smoking your skin, dude. and like smoke is flaming off of it. And there you go. That's what burnt skin smells like. It's fucking crazy gross, dude. Yeah, I don't know.
Like smell like protein?
No, I can't even.
Got like a pork smell to it?
No, dude, it had no smell.
A little bit of long
fucking hair. Animal at all. It was completely different.
Like alien?
Maybe I am. What of it? I don't know.
Felix, you got a jam?
Yeah, I got a song.
Hell yeah.
He's been sitting with a harmonica 4 inches away from his face for the last 10 minutes. He might have something
care.
Ready
I
for
I want to talk to Felix.
I want to get that fire. Yes, get fucking skin. Just I love it.
This one goes out to Talam in the chats, and Laser Lazzaroni.
Nice.
I wonder if she still exists.
She does.
She does. I've been seeing her on Twitter. I think she's having maybe a tough time.
Yep.
So this goes out. We. Cruising with Steak sends you a lot of love, Laser Lazzaroni.
Yeah, always.
Burn Laser as good Lazzaroni. Vibes.
Tons of good vibes.
I'll never forget. You're the first one to ever reach out to us, and thank you so much. And I always, hope you are doing well. So hang in there and just keep on trucking.
Keep on trucking.
Trucking.
Keep on trucking.
Yeah. That was a really bad joke.
Speaking of 78.
Yeah, man.
This is a Bob Dylan song called John Wesley Harding.
I hope it's 78.
And it's kind of, I think he's like an outlaw, true to life outlaw guy. And I think this is an album that came after when Dylan was kind of big in 1966 and he got his motorcycle accident and he didn't put out an album for like 4 or 5 years. And this is his kind of comeback album, I think. I think I might be right about that. And that has like all along the Watchtower on it. And
nice.
And it has this song. Here we go. All right. Is my video on? No? Okay.
Harding was a friend to the poor. He traveled with a gun in every hand. All along the countryside, he opened many a door. But he was never known to hurt an honest man. About with this lady by his side, he took a stand, and soon the situation there was all but straightened out, for he was always known to lend a helping hand. Move.
Felix.
Woo! Woo! Keep on trucking. Yeah, that's awesome.
John Wesley Harden, according to Time Life Books, once shot a man for snoring too loud in a boarding house.
Damn, son. Wow.
A little fun
fact. Snoring too loud.
Maybe I'm the reincarnation of him.
He claimed to have killed like 70 plus people and he went to jail for 17 years, I think.
Damn!
That's a long time for all those people.
Yeah, he was part of the gunfighters in the Time Life series. And I was a big fan as a kid.
Hey, maybe they asked for it.
I'm not programmed a bit, though.
But he says in the song that he never killed an honest man. Was he kind of?
I refuse to be programmed.
Dylan takes a little liberty with the truth for good rhymes. I mean, what's the song Hurricane he wrote about the boxer in jail?
I did a report on that in high school about the veracity of that claim.
He only wrote that song so he could blast an end, and everyone knows it.
That's the only reason.
You gotta serve somebody. Yep.
Just blast one out, get away with it for 50 years.
Dude, yeah, I like the Tim Steak reply in the CWS Meat Locker Discord chat. If you're not in there, get the fuck in there. And Tim Steak says, time life equals CIA life. Yeah. Dude, anything cool is related to a motherfucking three leather agency, right?
Pretty much. Sports ball.
They've all bought, they ended up buying it, you know, and just keeping the name like Facebook, stuff like that.
Dude, if we
wait, is Meat Locker, yeah. Meat Locker, you guys, the sports?
The CWS Meat Locker.
That's the Bench Wars.
Is the actual chat. It's in general. The whole entire.
It's called the Meat Locker?
It's called the Meat Locker, dude. Of course it is.
I thought it was just called General.
Gen Pop.
General chat.
No, well, that's Gen Pop. Is
the name of the server is the Meat Locker.
Is the Meat Locker, dude. Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Locker up.
Yeah, man. There's lots of cool terminology involved with our Discord server name. And there's tons of cool channels. If people are familiar with it or not,
if they aren't familiar with our exceptionally top of the fucking internet, best fucking meme channel in existence,
you
need to get in the CWS chat.
Look at that. That's a promo. Thanks, Zach.
Better than
the spiciest memes.
Oh, so spicy.
You can join the Discord chat for only $19.99 a month.
No doubt. That's how dope these memes are, I'm telling you.
Yeah, for only $19.99 a month, yeah. you can be serving the sickest anti-Semitic memes you've ever seen.
No doubt.
Armro gets spicy sometimes.
Yeah.
But for more, spicy in there. Yeah, you can even
love it.
Chuck out an extra buck and get to CWS
buck a month
patreon.com/
cruising with steak buck a month. Come on,
like CWS Patreon,
check it out.
Yeah,
get anything you want.
Come on, man,
it's only an extra buck.
So far in the meme channel,
so for $20
to get off of the
20 bucks, 20 bucks will get all of it. Yeah.
You'll never get off.
Yeah, then we'll give you a refund of $19. Yeah. And then it's crazy because it just all you need is a dollar and you'll get all of it, at least audio wise.
Buck a month. Also, we'll record that tomorrow night.
And while you're doing that, I can't do it tonight.
I'm off on Thursday. So
yeah, sweet.
Yeah, so one
second. And let's not forget to thank our sponsor, Regeneron, who brought us our hate mail segment. Regeneron.
Which exactly, yes.
Regeneron this dick.
Nope, we're going to have to rewrite that script. I don't know about that. Regeneron this dick. Regeneron this dick.
13 easy payments of $33.33.
I like it.
You can have Regeneron shipped to your home.
I thought it was free.
Well, it's free, but you have to fight people to the death.
Our Lord and Savior, Donald Trump.
In order to get it, yeah. But if you can pay for it to have it sent to your house.
But only in suppository form.
ShonenDump.com.
Right. Oh, man.
Share screen.
Oh, man.
Do that.
And what's only happening? Through CWS Patreon.
Yes, only through it.
James Cruz and Grimstead.
But then we'd have
James Cruz and Grimstead. Hey man. Oh, woo-hoo. G-R-I-M-S-T-A-K-N. Gmail.
I got a lot of hate mail tonight, you guys. Like, this might be like a 20-minute segment of just hate mail. I'm not gonna lie.
Good.
There's a lot of hate mail. But first hate mail we got comes from Sven.
Sven was writing early this morning.
Sven beat Booty Rooter by 35 minutes. That's what happened here. So, dude, Tuesday's emails start flowing in. Hello, Grimstake und Gaylord panel. Sven here. Sven leave Japan last week and fly to land of Oz, Australia. Sven find no wizard in land. Sven's sad because Sven like wizard. Sven kill two bird before leave Japan. Sven no kill tiny green Sven, so Sven feel like killing bird for fun. Sven now in Sydney, searching for tiny green Sven. Sven have weird dream with tiny green Sven. Sven see three light saucer flying and took good picture before Sven go to sleep. Sven try to shoot tiny green Sven with Sven's slingshot, but Sven rock no hits flying saucer. Hold on, Sven sent picture.
He sent
a picture of the saucer.
Oh my god, he tried to shoot the saucer with the slingshot?
I just posted the picture.
That's an XR3B we're looking at there.
My god, he's shooting a TR3B. Yeah.
With the slingshot. All right,
so he continues. Sven continues.
I love that. Thanks.
Tiny green Sven come to Sven dream and ask Sven.
Now people know what's up.
Why Sven try to kill tiny green Sven? Sven tell tiny green Sven that killing bird was no challenge, and tiny green Sven hard to kill. Tiny green Sven then say, come with me, Sven. I show you tiny green Sven ship. Sven then fly through roof in a tiny green Sven saucer flying. Sven could no move arms und legs. Sven could wiggle finger one at time. But tiny green Sven saw wiggle and slap Sven on nose. Tell Sven no move. Tiny green Sven tie Sven to silver table. Sven see tiny blue Sven doctors come out of wall hole. Blue Sven doctors start to take Sven off Sven's clothes. See tiny green Sven dog come out of wall hole next.
Dog wall?
Sven get more scared now. Sven remind of Sven dog rape Sven sister Svendy and leave Sven dog sauce on Svendy butt.
No!
Sven
this
worry
is another
tiny
dog.
Green.
This is the first dog he's seen since that. Oh, no.
Sven worry tiny green Sven dog rape Sven and leave tiny green Sven dog sauce in Sven butt.
Oh.
Sven start crying. Tiny blue Sven doctor tells Sven not to be pussy like cry and cry like girl. Then tiny blue Sven doctor tells Sven to take deep breath. Tiny blue Sven doctor put hose in Sven butt. Make Sven feel like girl. Sven cry more. Tiny blue Sven doctor hose squirt tiny blue Sven doctor sauce into Sven butthole. Sven scream, then Sven wake up. Sven find tiny blue wet spot in Sven bed after Sven wake up. Sven not know if tiny blue Sven doctor was real. But Sven want kill tiny blue Sven doctor now too.
We can't
Sven
take
butthole
it anymore.
Today. Goodbye until next report. Super love and Sven sauce. Love for you for reals.
Wait, what?
Dude,
no.
I think that was all a dream.
It was a dream.
Yeah, but he woke up with a tiny blue
bank.
What's
yeah,
Christ.
Woke up with, yeah, he had dreams. Next one's from Booty Rooter. Dear Grimstake. I'm watching the Supreme Court drama unfold, and it has now given me an idea as to how fix your god awful show is. They keep talking
how
about
to fix? Yeah, okay.
How to fix your god awful show. Okay, there we go. Thank you, James. You read it through my brain somehow.
I read it. I thought of what you were reading. Yeah.
They keep talking about packing the court to prevent it from being dominated by conservative ideals. I think that we should pack Cruisin' with Steaks so that it is no longer dominated by jinkos, fake news, and people who see demons everywhere. As such, I am hereby ordering CWS merge with Pod Save America. Have fun, Rocky.
Thanks, Rocky. All right,
we could do that.
I think it might be a great fit, you know? You never know.
Okay.
It's worth a shot.
Damn, this is a serious one. It says, from the law offices of Gold Raper and Bang.
Oh.
Whoa.
Mr. Matambe, good luck, Chang, a citizen of the Democratic Republic of Congo, engaged Gold Raper and Bang to represent his business interests in the United States. These business interests include import-export, natural resource development, and clothing distribution. The father of Matambe Chang was the now deceased Chang, son of Chang, longtime residents of Pigmaozhou, Xinjiang Province, People's Republic of China. As you may know, Matambe Chang's father and grandfather were political dissidents, but what you may not know is that they were fabulously wealthy. In Chang's last will and testament, he named Matambe Chang to be the executor of his estate.
Absolutely splendid.
This estate includes several billion Yugoslav dinars, 31 shipping containers packed to the ceiling with right shoes, and a large collection of yaoi porn featuring thin butchers who vape.
Yahweh!
Chang's browsing history and email sent items folder indicate that he was committed to the Cruising with Steak podcast. And look to the wise words of someone named Grim Steak as a moral compass for the pro tips to being a power bottom. To show his appreciation for the... God damn it.
Holy shit, man.
If the show title isn't "I got an email from a Mongolian princess," I don't know what.
Shows appreciation for years of enjoyment he received from the podcast. Chang has requested in his will that Mr. Steak be gifted with any right shoe of his choice from the collection, and that Mr. James Cruz receive a chunk of drywall from the prison cell where he died.
Yes, yes, please.
Matambe Chang would like to congratulate you on your good fortune and thank you for the years of enjoyment that you have provided to his late father. Without your selfless support, Chang would have been shot in the face instead of in the back and the head, and for that, Matambe is grateful. Please see the attached invoice for the payment of shipping fees and import duties associated with a portion of the estate settlement. Also, please include credit card numbers, expiration dates, CVV codes, and mother maiden name to expedite the delivery of your portion of the estate. Sincerely, Overton Bang Esquire, Managing Partner, Gold Raper and Bang LLC.
Esquire? Awesome.
All right.
Nice.
This next
man,
one.
Everyone just had their coffee this morning to crank out a good 8 mail.
Unbelievable.
That
dude.
One sounded like a that mail, if I'm being honest.
A that
James
mail.
James' background narrating has thrown me off at least 40 times.
I'm sorry.
Oh, fuck. God, shit.
You're killing me, dude. I'm like, oh, man. Yes. The stuff is just phenomenal. Like, the thought of these people going through these hard times. I mean, just unbelievable. And then they take the time to write us this?
Are we going
to
play Ludicrous Hard Times now? That's man.
Whatever background.
I fucking hope so.
Because,
All right, we got more hate mails, James. We got to power through. We got a lot
going,
more hate
dude.
Mails.
I'm sorry.
All right, this one's from Melodis in the Discord. He says, "What's up, fucktards?" That's the title. Hello,
thank
boys.
You.
I know it's been only 3 months since the region has rid of itself of the menace Grimstake. Now the sun shines every day and the air is smelling cleaner, the birds are all singing, and the schools no longer have to worry about that short-eyed motherfucker combing the parking lots at 3 o'clock. I never did that. This is all fake.
I never did it.
Slandering you.
I'm just getting slandered so hard.
Across the Midwest.
Yes.
Just tarnishing your reputation as a Midwestern good boy.
I know. You're not missed one bit. And James, I would like to congratulate you on your beautiful daughter. Please don't ever tell her a rag and a can of ether was involved in her conception. Okay.
It's the ether.
It's the ether. As for the rest of the crew, what the fuck is wrong with you? 2 hours of your life every week, you'll never get that back. Grimstake enjoys sucking the hopes and dreams for your reality. Thanks for nothing, fuckers. Just another fucktard who can't stop listening. Chad C. Melantis in the Discord. P.S. Suzanne, get out while there's still time. Suzanne can't get out.
To leave California.
Suzanne was born with cruising with steak. She's the backbone.
I think that California.
Exactly.
Oh man. Oh god, this next one's
get out.
This next one's from Poop Slinger. So you know, we're about
here
to get chatted on hard.
It's about to be mountain lion related. I can tell
you know it is. Hate mail for all the juggalos and juggalettes. What a snow chase.
You don't throw the rock, you use it as a hammer.
Please. Please, let's hear the same tired shit about the pandemic and masks are dumb and all the alt-right boomer platitudes this collection of aging nerds has been recycling all year. Or about how it's so impossible that old buildings could have ever been built by American men, by a bunch of soy boys who feel accomplished assembling IKEA furniture. Drop all the queermo, Bush League, political and conspiratorial shit. Conspiratard shit for more Felix jams and stories from Papa Jimmy. America, poop slinger. Damn.
He did 100 shed lifts after that.
100 shed lifts.
Yeah, he did.
He's
brilliant.
Atlas
totally.
Stones.
500 crunches one. After that, too.
Next one's from Duel. Oh, and he wrote this all in fucking Scottish lingo.
Oh,
jeez.
Boy.
Okay. It says, killing some animals. Grim Jamie and all those others. What's the problem with that, wee Sven? I went to me rifle and shot 6 deers the day. I'm a murdering bastard. 6 deer got put doon in the mootins that day. Meat for the locker all through winter. Staghorns on me wall. Dinny carry a boot, you're killing Sven. Shooter, stand aside, you bass. Duel. And then he says love to everyone.
Love you, Duel.
Duel.
I like the rest of the meat locker.
Nice.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, damn. This one's... Oh, shit. What's happening, you guys? This one's titled, This is the Real Chang. Please help me.
Oh, shit.
It says, oh, man.
What? Help me, Grimsteak. Oh, help me, James Cruz. Help me, People Steak with Cruz podcast. Chinese government lied to you and said me and boyfriend Chang are dead. Don't believe 5.6. Chinese government wiped my memory and placed me on MasterChef season 9 as Chang. This is cruel joke. When you mention his name on Patreon episode, I wake up from my memory wipe and now I'm in control of Chang. I have finally escaped and I'm looking for gay boyfriend Chang. If anyone in Steak Show with James Cruzen knows what happened to Chang, please let me know.
Wow.
That's from Chang. Damn.
Oh,
so
man,
apparently Chang subscribes
alive
to the Patreon, and when we were playing the clips from MasterChef, he got awakened. God damn.
It just, so it turns out that it just so happened, just a coincidence, that Chang from MasterChef season 9 also happened to be listening to the Crucible Steak Patreon.
So here's some fucked up shit. There's the guy that I called Chang in MasterChef season 9. You know, that's funny. You know, because he's very Changly. MasterChef season 10 legit has a guy named Fred Chang in it. So I'm just getting like MasterChef is just changing me to death. So
they
I
are
put changing that out
you
there
to death.
We have one more hate mail. Final hate mail. Dear Grim and James, I just want to tell a story. There was a cat down by the river, and a sausage came floating by the cat, put its paws in, and wet its paws. Then a few minutes later, a bigger sausage came floating by the cat and the cat fell in. The moral of this story, the bigger the sausage, the wetter the pussy. Thank you for doing your show. It makes me laugh in these difficult times. Shonen Dump is the real podcast. Up with Trump, dying with Biden. Thanks, Buster Cherry. P.S. I like to tinker on JDMs, Japanese domestic market cars, and have a 96 Pontiac Grand Am. It has a heavy clunking when stopping and the same chunk when moving from time to time. There's a bowling ball in the trunk. So much fail. Thanks, Buster Cherry. Much appreciated. Show the Dump is the real podcast. And that's it for hate mail, you guys. God damn.
That's a lot.
That's a lot of hate mail.
Yeah, we got it. It was flowing in today. The hate mail flowed.
The hate was just flowing with everyone.
And if you
want to
send any sort of mail, love mail, hate mail, anything you honestly want, grimsteak @gmail.com. I will read it. On the
preferably
air.
Make it in the conjoined Sven Chang Matumbo.
Please make it hard to read. We right. love hearing Grimsteak struggle.
Oh, they're struggling all the time.
I want to encourage everyone to make up their own.
Yes.
Their own personas.
Right. Fan fiction. And then start a story, fan fiction. It's fun.
Kind of whatever
it's
you want.
What it is. And just, I hate that term, dude. Yeah.
Anything but that.
You're right.
Like, no, for fuck's sake, diapers. I would prefer over fur shit. Like,
oh man,
just plagiarize them from Time Life books,
dude.
There you go.
There's some talk. Yeah. There was some talk in the Tunes and Jams channel about mosh pits. Like, and I just pulled this up and I was just kind of cruising through the chat for a minute because I don't feel like playing sound effects at the moment. And because we were, Flavortown was posting some badass music earlier and then we got talking about mosh pits. He's like, man, I'm not really a mosh pit guy. I'd rather like chill out and enjoy the show. I'm like, yeah, that's me. And when I played, if my friends were playing a show, you'd get out there and try to like start the pit, you know, like you try to get it going. And, like when there's like no one like getting into it, but you know their music and shit, you know the little breakdowns and the little tricks.
Yeah, hard to get it started.
Oh, fuck yeah, it's hard, dude. Yeah. So you try to help your friends.
Once it does, though.
So you get it going, but at the same time, dude. And then Zach, you fucking laid out the story about getting stepped on, right?
Oh so yeah, my fucking happened. Toe stomped
everybody
on.
Here,
holy shit!
Like, how many people do you know that are involved with mosh pits or are always getting their toes smashed? And they, my wife has lost like 4 toenails because of that. Yeah, right? No joke, dude.
It's not a situation to be taken lightly.
No,
watch out for them.
Yeah, man, you're like, imagine being a little, or I'm saying a little girl, but being a girl in the mosh pit and getting your fucking foot stepped on by some like 250 guy. You know, like,
it's what made me appreciate having steel toed shoes.
Yes,
was mosh pits. Yes. Yep.
So then you're just going around and crushing motherfuckers in the pits with steel toed shoes,
dude. Just doing the stomp, boom.
With just the steel toe on it, you couldn't be fucked up. Like,
girl in
people could stomp as hard as they wanted. They couldn't fuck with that steel toe.
Steel toe. And the whole
had the little screw on the heel parts.
Oh,
where you could stomp on people.
Girl in a Mosh Pit is a good show title.
Yeah, I like that, Felix.
Build back better.
Yeah.
Right.
Dying with Biden. Like that? Then we can't use
dying
that.
With Biden.
a while ago, our neighbor
up with Trump.
neighbor across the street had a sign that said Biden, I guess.
Oh,
and then they switched fully to Biden.
I've been seeing a lot that say by Don. Bye, Donald.
Ah, Donnie. Bye, bye, Donnie. Donnie. Don. Yeah,
vote by Don.
Got him.
Yeah. Dude, it's insane.
So let's talk about these toenails, Zach. I mean, what happened, dude? Like,
that's almost show title. Let's talk about these toenails.
Yeah,
that's a show title.
I mean, these are issues that people in the music industry have. And yeah, like, you go to these shows, dude. I know so many people that have their fucked up toes about it. Yeah, like.
Yep. It was, I had a toenail that was growing too much on one side and it was cutting into the skin of the toe, right?
Right.
I had got it cut off.
It's painful, like, as fuck.
There's
and then we'd do a fucking metal show and guess what? Somebody stomped on my foot.
Boom!
Can you imagine?
Punch him in the face. Yeah.
You guys
tried to. I probably punched the wrong person in the face, honestly, but whatever.
Honestly, yeah.
I got to leave the show, you know.
You got all these important issues. You got Roe v. Wade.
Yeah.
Toe v. Wade.
Uh-huh.
Toe v. Wade. Nice. Toe v.
Wade.
Toe v. Wade. Yeah.
All kinds of choices.
All these crazy issues. Yeah. Toe v.
Wade. They're going to repeal toe. I'm telling you that right now.
They're
going to
repeal it, man. They're going to tear it off. They're going to break it off.
You can never uncut the toe.
Yeah. Cut all that. Yeah. They cut. So they have to go in and cut the angle out. I know it's crazy. Like my wife hasn't, her foot, it's been smashed a billion times or whatever from all these old shows, and sure enough, like, it's basically you're better off getting them taken off and you put on like these fake things. It's crazy. So yeah, her Lee press-on nails are toenails. They're not fingernails. It's pretty crazy. I mean, I don't You don't want to be spitting out all your woman's shit, but that's what it is.
That's what it is.
I don't
is.
Give
she's
a
got,
fuck.
She's got fake toenails.
Yeah, about four of them. Because
prosthetic toes?
Because of mosh pits. Yes.
Ooh. I got something coming.
Cruising with Stay.
Yeah.
Buttons work.
Technology segment. Cruising with Stay. Technology segment.
Maybe you can teach me how to use a computer, Jerry, to know how the buttons work.
Teach me how to computer.
I need to know how buttons work.
Teach me how to computer.
I need to know how buttons work. Buttons work.
Right? Brought to you by Regeneron.
Brought to you by Regeneron. So we got some tech news. There's a new LiDAR function on the new iPhones.
Nice.
Flavortown, break down what's going on, because you were jerking off about Apple today.
That is amazing.
Jerry was getting so pissed because he was unleashing demons on the chat.
He's like, my phone doesn't have LiDAR on it.
No, that's not why he was pissed.
So the new iPhone 12 Pros, so only the Pro variants, will have a LiDAR. I don't know if that's a scanner or a sensor. I don't know exactly what the term would be. So for anyone who doesn't know what that is, you're one, retarded. And second, it is a method for measuring distances by illuminating the target with laser light and measuring the reflection with a sensor.
You listen back to our episode on YouTube with Jeffrey Boyd Jr. where he talked about LiDAR.
Is that an acronym?
James
acronym
is gone.
For something?
Is it? That's
like,
a good
probably like
question.
Longitudinal something or other.
Etymology. It was originally called Collidar for coherent light detecting and ranging. So there you go.
And ranging. Yeah.
That's I guess what it is. So the new ones have LiDAR sensors. So the pitch is you're able to like, they're trying to do like for construction or for like home decorating or something, there'll be, you know, some apps that'll scan your room and figure out where all of your shit needs to be, like augmented reality shit, essentially.
Pokemon Go.
Kind of. It'd be like if you turned your living room into, and then like an augmented reality version of your living room is now inside your phone that you can manipulate and do different things with. Does that make sense? Like you could theoretically design things and using the confines of the area around you and like, you know, see what a particular piece of furniture would look like in your house or something like that. So it could scan your room and put it in there and make you see an image of that or something along those lines.
Yeah, so you just have augmented reality all around your world.
But the other part of it is that there's always a sensor on in your camera, or there is a sensor in your camera that at any time, in theory, could get turned on to scan the entirety of your whereabouts.
Which would be on all
sounds
the time.
Sounds cancerous too.
It does sound pretty cancerous.
Well, imagine playing Pokemon Go and think you weren't helping map the interior spaces of areas for Google Maps. Like, just, you know, you're Pokemon Go and don't think it's mapping everything.
Right. So that's it mapped true. Everything with Pokemon Go, and now they're just going to have a piece of hardware in there to get even more accurate, because things change, things move around. If you have LiDAR, you can theoretically go almost down to the product level. Like you can figure out what products
taint
are
level.
In your home.
Oh, like taint.
Yeah.
I thought you were talking about taint.
Or that. And so it's a pretty, and of course they're all 5G enabled. I mean, do I even have to say it? Do I even have to say they're all going to be 5G ready to go?
Said it.
I just said it now. So fuck LiDAR. Don't have that. I mean, because you're one terms of service away from like even crazier, like
anal
weird shit. Yeah, some weird shit.
LiDAR.
Jerry, have you ever owned an Apple device?
Did you see the...
That's why his soul's so pure. You could see it through his
soul. He glows.
That's why he exudes dragon
energy. Never a PC or anything?
He's got a human glow.
The Acer.
Oh, there it is.
Oh, look at that. What is that? Like a 2000?
He's got a MacBook there. Yeah.
MacBook.
Looks like
Did you guys see the Mario Kart augmented reality Mario Kart?
Oh my God, it sounds
RC
amazing.
Car game.
No, it sounds awesome.
I don't know where I saw it, but it has. I'm pretty
what
sure
do I plug in?
There's a camera on a physical RC car of Mario.
Oh, that's sweet.
And I don't know if on the controller, it might be a Switch thing. I don't know what console it's on, but you actually see what the RC car sees, and then it puts like a whole entire racetrack arena in your house. So you make space in your house, and then you race the car around and look at the screen, and you're basically driving through your living
Mario room. Kart through your house. That's awesome. Yeah.
And it makes just like boundaries and whatever, you know.
Yeah, it sees a wall or something. You would go up a wall maybe. Cool. Yeah. Yeah. That sounds fucking amazing, dude. Yeah.
Yeah. I think it does boundaries.
Is that a Nintendo Switch? Is that a Nintendo Switch thing? Then?
Look it up.
I could have dreamt it
and it's not real.
Yeah.
It's too plausible not to be real at this point.
Augmented.
Wife is waking me.
It sounds like something that I was.
I talk in my sleep. Are you guys sleep talkers at all?
I don't know.
I don't know, but I bet your motherfucking phone is listening though.
It's on Nintendo Switch, Mario.
Dude, I definitely sleep talker. I'll start like, because when I'm in like that like in between state, like I know like what's going on, but I know that I'm sleeping, right? But I know I'm dreaming at the same time, and that's when you can start controlling things, right? So like, yeah, so I'm listening. It's like you're listening and watching this thing play out in your brain, right? Or whatever, this film, and you can act upon these things or not. But I tend to blurt out like the ending of these things all the time. So the other day, it would have been just yesterday morning. She's telling me, she's like, you're talking like crazy. You kept talking about 1994. I'm like, of course I did. I was like, that's the last time the Browns were 4-1.
I thought you should talk about Chicago Bulls.
Yeah, no, man. Yeah. Cleveland Browns. Yeah. Like, I mean, that's like ingrained in my head. So 94, and then the last like 3 days, yeah, or, you know, like it's all this 94, dude, fucking around Brownstown here. So everyone's all amped up and jerking off all over the place, dude. It's fucking crazy, dude. Loving it.
All of my night terrors, and if there's like a little bit of light bleeding into my room, my eyes play tricks on me.
Yeah.
Like when my eyes are open a little.
I always feel like there's somebody watching me.
I either see my wife looking like a corpse, or I see like our walls crumbling. And my go-to phrase is, holy shit. Holy shit.
Holy shit.
Holy shit. I never say holy shit when I'm like awake. Yeah.
Right,
but I'll say it when it's like something seriously like reality bending in my night terrors.
Wow, dude!
Holy shit! Yeah, like something spiritual.
I would be screaming it out, dude. Like, cause it's just weird. Like, I know what I'm doing. I know I'm actually talking, and I know like it's so messed up. Like, you're on the verge of like being right there, but you're not there. It's so cool. It's so weird. I don't know.
That's not
like remote viewing or anything. That's just consciousness. Like, yeah, like the different stages of being oneself. Yeah. the stages of sleep, you know, those kind of things.
And I camped out this weekend.
I know.
Sunday night, we were in a campground, state park campground.
Do you have any dreams?
Not really. The guy next door to me snored so loud inside a pop-up.
He killed my night. Yes.
He had a wife and daughter in there with him.
You just saw them.
There was no way anybody was sleeping. No.
Earplugs.
We have noise-canceling headphones in our family. Yeah.
I was in a tent, open air, snoring, man.
Did you catch any squatch out there, or see anything, any knocks?
We
Arrowheads?
We went to a place that was supposed to have been sacred ground. Yeah. I got a little itchy at the top of the hill. We were getting mosquito bit quite a bit.
Yeah. Man.
Yeah. Those things are still around?
Guys, I've been watching a
big time.
My wife and my youngest son for like the past year, they've been watching like every episode of Naked and Afraid. Like, because it's on Hulu, they have like 8 seasons of it on there. so they've seen them all, and now I'm up there at night now too, so I'm watching them, because before, primarily because of my kicking and punching and talking and all that stuff, I don't sleep in my bed, dude. No one would sleep. I'm insane. Yeah,
like a bat cave.
Just fighting people in your.
Oh, dude. Yeah. Hey, I watch a lot of anime, and I learn things, and these things get acted out when I sleep. It's awesome.
You gotta wear a straight jacket to sleep.
Yeah. I gotta swaddle myself.
James, you had to take all the katanas out of the house. Yeah. You kept clicking them.
Yeah,
and you're
man.
Sleeping,
dude,
cutting everybody.
Oh, the kunai. There's no kunais in this house at all.
To get all the kunais out.
I put peanut butter and jelly out with my finger because no one trusts me with a knife. Yeah.
Don't want to give him an excuse to get that good grip.
But you put peanut butter on your finger because
no one trusts me with knives in this house. There's no knives. So I have to spread the peanut butter with my jam on finger.
Give him the slippery hand. The slippery hand. I know what you mean.
Finger.
That's grimy.
Yeah. Especially when it's the chunky peanut butter with the nuts in it.
People still eat that?
It's a little green. I fucked up and bought... Dude, you guys always fuck up. I've done it a few times and you buy the wrong one, right? Yeah, like you're like, oh, damn.
Hold up. So chunky is the wrong one? Like, I don't mind a good
not
chunky
necessarily.
Peanut butter.
Chunky is
chunky
wrong.
Peanut butter.
Hold up. Chunky peanut butter is superior in every way.
Okay. I'm glad I got a little support
here. Yeah, because in the superior way of like you can serve it on little different things, you have more options with
it, right? Because it's just objectively the better version of peanut butter. Yeah.
It's
Another question. How do you guys like your orange? How do you guys like your orange juice? You like some pulp?
Throw
pulp
in there and let me fucking eat it.
You guys are disgusting. Just go drink some seaweed.
Oh, James is a no pulp boy.
That's insane.
He's a no pulp boy.
So disgusting.
He likes some fucking smooth and gay.
Squeeze it out the orange.
So gay, dude. And it was funny too. I saw an article when I was scrolling through Twitter, and it said the diet. It said the dying of iceberg lettuce. Like people aren't eating that shit anymore because it's fucking garbage.
No, you should be
eating
romaine because iceberg
you gotta clean
shit.
It.
No one's buying iceberg lettuce anymore because
is that because you gotta clean
garbage.
It?
I don't know. It was on Twitter. I
look at so
look it up.
You gotta clean it.
No.
But what I'm
saying
is,
you probably have to clean it. They always had COVID on that shit, right, or whatever, or whatever disease is always on lettuce.
It was it's like the neurovirus, or they'd have all that shit. But that just happens on any kind of produce.
On any food,
like, dude,
any
there'd
travel,
be melons and shit. Yeah. Produce would be getting pulled all the time for having some sort of outbreak or E. coli or some shit on it.
Oh, people don't get food poisoning anymore. I don't know if you knew that.
Yeah, it doesn't happen anymore.
Yeah, they just die of COVID.
Why the hell would I take a test?
2019.
Yeah. No. Jesus.
Come on, man.
Yeah.
Come on, man.
Peanut butter.
Yeah.
All right, you guys do anything artistic out there?
No, I found out, though, that my birthday, like Pisces or whatever, is like artistic people. So that's what I mean. Like, I found these stupid little things before the show.
It's like a revelation.
And a lot of 78s lately, which is fun and exciting.
Records?
I don't know why. No, just in general, the 78. I was born and you know, all these shows are going on, all these cool things are happening, like just stuff like that. That's the year I was born.
I'm gonna make a
in the winter 78. Yeah, so yeah.
I'm gonna make two hoverboards out of
let's talk about
wood. And print the decals and make a hoverboard to mount on my wall, like the Back to the Future hoverboard.
You gonna try to have them? You put some lighting under it or something cool, like an LED.
Slap it on the wall. I could do
like a shadow box, like or shadow effect, like just have some blocks behind it or something and have them like floating on your wall.
Just on the wall.
Yeah. Okay.
No floating.
Oh,
techniques.
Just decks on the wall, dude. That's that's an art thing at this point. I mean, dude, go to your skate shop. It's phenomenal. The artwork and shit on skateboards is ridiculous. it's still awesome. It's almost like my background. I mean, the shit is so colorful and amazing. And like, yeah, it's, I bought a new deck just because it looks so dope. I bought the whole damn thing and just supported your local skate shop.
Tech so,
hell yeah.
No, man, I bought a full complete deck for like $120. Yeah, it was ridiculous.
What kind of wood?
And it's a 7-ply maple, and standard skateboard, but it's constructed a little bit longer, a little bit wider, because I'm a little bit longer and a little bit wider.
Does it got USB port?
No. Nah, it has the wider truck.
We all?
It has wider trucks and cruiser wheels on it. And so I can still rip around a park, though, and like at the same time just be comfortable on a little bit bigger of a board. Skater.
A little bit more stability. Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know.
I mean,
I have only ridden it a few times. A few times I've gotten on it. The dumbest things take me out, like a pebble in the fucking parking lot. You know, there's I have like, you know, a giant like 500 car parking lot, and I get and it's completely empty. I'm just ripping around like me and the kids and shit. And then yeah, just randomly you hit these pebbles and I go flying. And
do you
I'm an old
do you
dude.
Wear wrist braces?
I don't wear shit. I'm just fucking protection. I change into my skate shoes and so I have a little bit more like
you're protected enough
skate
for the DC
shoes,
side.
It,
you're
man.
Good.
Yeah, I got my regular my skate
slip on
Vans.
My etnies.
They're Vans. I have nice. My blue Vans,
classic,
and I throw those on and I just go at it for as long as I can, basically. And I get a little ballsier. I start ollieing over manhole covers and shit.
Nice.
Yeah, I was blowing my youngest son away with that shit. He's like, it's all wet. I'm like, check this out. It's like three pushes and I fucking crack an ollie and over the manhole and the puddle. Boom, dude, 42.
Perfection.
Boom. Wow. Just slammed
you must be,
it.
You must
that
be
was
doing,
like this, that was the first try too, and the second try I didn't eat it, but like I just kept spitting the board out.
you're probably doing performance enhancing.
Totally, yeah, yes. Probably. I was probably definitely high. I would imagine
it was all those fumes off of the new baby getting you high and injecting.
No, this was up. This was pre babe. Yeah.
Did you like my idea about taking your baby's poops and converting it into energy?
I forget about that one.
I've heard of people taking kind of poops from the
like a compost thing,
putting it in like a chamber and letting it create methane and taking that energy.
It sounds like what they use in the power supply for the car in Back to the Future, like two. Remember they had that Mr.
Fusion?
Fusion, yes, yeah. Yeah. Sounds like something you would put in there, like a diaper. Yeah, you drop in a dirty dipe, dude, and like it's got all the parts you need. That's crazy. Yeah. Mr. Fusion. I like it. That reminds me of the old popcorn maker that like my grandma, I'm sure he still has it. It's just like, yeah, I don't remember what brand or anything, but growing up through the 80s over my grandparents, they had the popcorn thing with the thing off the top of it. Yeah, and it just fill that shit up. Yeah. All these things are sparking memories. I love sharing stupid shit with everybody. Yeah. So that's all I'm doing here. And we do a podcast. This is a show, right? Yeah. I mean, what other people got?
We got a big lead up to like the spookiness of Halloween.
Halloween, we can do that.
It's Spooktober.
Yeah.
God damn.
Guys. You're like halfway through October and you haven't done anything spooky.
Hey, we need to start spooking it up. Yet. Yeah. Ooh, man, we need to do a crypt. Play
the
crypt.
That's why I brought the bone story.
Oh,
we'll do some spooky segments next week. We'll get them.
Yeah, we could do that. It's
all spooky back to back.
We got like 5 minutes left.
Yeah. I got a weird story, not necessarily a spooky one. You guys ever hear of Oliver, Human Z?
Yeah, I have actually.
Sounds familiar.
I started watching this documentary on YouTube about him. It's fucking crazy. I feel like he might have been a human monkey hybrid.
Possible.
What's his name?
His name's Oliver the monkey. So
because I know it.
They claimed he was found in the Congo. So this Oliver started doing chores. This is an excerpt that I found, that he would often feed the animals and use tools like a wheelbarrow when loads were too much to handle. He used to drink coffee and cocktails and would apparently mix his own drinks.
And smoke cigarettes?
Oh, really?
Yeah. They say it wasn't just mimicry because he was able to just like make his own decisions and overcome obstacles on his own.
What?
And he was also sexually attracted to human females.
Wow.
James, yeah.
He comes from China.
But because he had monkey strength, you know, retard strength, they couldn't let him. They wouldn't let him get too close. So yeah, he was passed around in circuses. the documentary has a little bit of stuff on him, not a whole lot.
There's a picture of him and Columbus together.
Yeah,
in a Civil War battle.
That's fucking great, Nikki. Yeah.
Wait, is it from like the 1800s?
It was from
Columbus and this dude. Yeah. A selfie too. Yeah, like he's got his arm up and shit.
1800s.
Yeah, he has his arm up.
70s. Yeah. This was in the 70s.
The 1970s
or 78? Yeah. I hope it's
78.
1978. If it is, it'd be fucking. It
he was
phenomenal.
No, it wasn't. Wait, hold on. That just says 1970. He was acquired.
Oh, 70. Yeah. Okay.
Oh, they meant 1670, of course.
I think he was spotted with Charleston Heston. It's in a NRA meeting.
Oh, Charles Heston? Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Charles Heston, exactly.
Charles.
That's what his friends call him.
Hot Charles.
Call him Hot Charles. Hot Charles. Hot Charles found a Bigfoot.
Human Z.
Human Z.
Dick Cheney?
So that's what who Bigfoot is.
I
want to
see if there's any like pictures or footage of him on this.
Ooh.
Oh, there's a shot.
He's pointing at a picture. And
he's
looks
the
like,
Pope.
It looks like it looks like a fucking monkey.
I think it was just because he was a.
Is this him?
Damn.
Might be him. Yeah.
It's goddamn chimpanzee.
Whoa.
He doesn't really look much like a regular
look
monkey.
At that stare.
He gets
looks
nice.
Like a hot Carl to me.
Oh man, he's into auto asphyxiation too.
Yeah, he's all strangled up.
Yeah.
You're like, watch, so, he bites.
Great for
yeah, because he's a chimpanzee.
Oh, nice laptop.
Yeah, for real. And then he got a projector on the wall. Yeah.
Oh yeah, they had him in a Japanese. Apparently, he started off in like a Japanese theme park.
Damn, he eats bananas.
Yeah, he's peeling the banana and shit. Yeah, he's got shorts on.
Yeah.
Oh, weird.
Just nice. Like a human.
Oh, you can control a television camera.
Hey, is that
fishing? Oh, if he goes fishing, I'll be fucking blown away. If he starts casting out a rod, he gets a rod.
Oh, that's a robotic eye, 100%.
Oh shit! It's fucking AI ape.
That guy looked like Seymour Hoffman.
Seymour Hoffman. So good.
After a bender.
Man.
I'm just going to go ahead and nominate. He's all
Twister.
Strangled Up is show title.
All Strangled Up?
We already got show titles.
He's all strangled up.
Oh, man. Show titles have been
I thought Toe versus Wade.
Sponsored by Regeneron.
Yes, that's a good one, dude.
I mean, that's kind of with the times right now. In the last day or so. I actually came home and I think I turned it on Twitter and they brought up it was right when she talked about the stupid notepad thing.
Oh, Amy Coney Barrett and that shit.
How do you know all
like,
this shit? And they're like, what do you got written down?
Notepad.
Yeah, she holds up a blank sheet of paper. She's like, they're just like, she knows all, yeah, knows it all. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, she's gonna go through. There's nothing they can get her on.
Yeah. It's crazy. Like, she's just sitting there, just taking it. These old fucking white guys.
One last little bit about that story that I'll mention is that in 1977, a researcher named Michael Bedford discovered that human sperm could penetrate the protective outer membranes of a gibbon egg. Which genetically is the ape furthest from humans.
Oh no. It seems as if
scientifically
somebody's banging some apes. That's crazy.
Yeah, it seems as if scientifically it is possible for a human to
have human trials.
Oh no.
So
who got nominated to I guess they did it via squirt shot.
We would hope so.
Yeah,
there was that documentary. Like,
Fred, you're up.
Fuck among us.
Yeah, Fred, you're up.
She was asking for it.
Oh man. Yeah.
If only she hadn't worn it.
Why she kept looking
at it. Television for that night.
Yeah.
I've had no monkey babies, just FYI.
Yeah,
let's talk about the Jews here.
No,
there was a Russian scientist in the late 1920s who tried very hard to make a human monkey hybrid, and it says that he claimed that he failed, but who knows?
Got
pretty close.
He German by any chance?
No, he was Russian.
He's Russian.
Oh,
he's literally the most Russian name I've ever heard. It's Ilya Ivanovich Ivanov.
Yeah, that's
literally just a fake.
It's pretty fucking Russian, yeah.
I talked earlier.
He got right off the morphine trains, and they just stamped.
He got right off.
Vague shit you've ever heard in your fucking life.
These are my kids.
Yeah.
I'll take two, please.
Jerry, who got on Nox Mente tomorrow night?
He's muted.
Oh, he's muted.
Yeah, he'll get there. What did we call
it? He'll figure it out.
He has to finish masturbating.
Oh, was it Dox Mente? No.
Dox Mente. Yeah, someone was getting doxed.
Somebody got doxed. Yeah, yeah.
I had a laugh about that.
Yeah, Dox Mente. Yeah.
Tomorrow night we have an obelisk with Thomas Sheridan.
Oh, nice. Mm-hmm. That'll be good.
Woohoo.
Sheridan, yeah.
Last time he was on, you guys got a shitload of views, didn't you?
Highest food show, 300.
Highest food show?
3,500 views, something like that.
Nice.
Fucking shit.
Hell yeah.
This should be good, though. We're going to talk about internet demons.
Yes. Yeah.
Yes.
You know, it's
internet.
Gonna be all
three.
Talk about the iPhone LiDAR coming out.
LiDAR.
The 12? What's 12? Reduce it.
Uh-oh. Three. It's three, right? Yeah. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
The lowest common denominator, is that what they say? Is that
James? How do you know this shit?
I have no clue. And that just popped in my head because you're like, oh, what was the thing? And I'm like, well, the lowest of 12 would be three. I don't know.
But we don't know.
Yeah, but we don't know. James, I don't know how I.
James is secretly a gematria savant.
He is.
Totally. Yeah. I was just trying to get the terminology of lowest common denominator out of my mouth.
Hell yeah.
So next week is
the lowest common denominator.
Next week we're getting spooky. Let's get real.
Yeah, let's do it. Everyone
bring a
spooky
story. Song.
Yes.
Hell yeah. Patreon will come out tomorrow.
Song.
Tomorrow
spooky.
Night.
Ooh, that'll be fun.
Nice.
Maybe I'll get spooky tomorrow night too. We'll have some fun.
I got some spooky stories.
Hey, can I do a promo?
Promo?
Yeah, promo it up. Promo it up.
Go check out SirFelix.bandcamp.com, baby.
Definitely.
Check it out.
Nice.
Get some albums.
Check it out.
I got some new ones coming out here soon, so I just...
Oh, hell yeah.
Felix, I want to do some background vocals with you or something.
Yes, James.
I want to lay down a track with you.
We need 5G to make that happen.
Uh-huh. But no, I can lay down some tracks and you can...
Just
like
drive to Wisconsin.
Yeah.
Record it in studio.
Oh, I could do that. Yeah.
Dude, get the 12, the Apple 12.
Reality concert.
Did we even talk about that crap?
Oh yeah.
I missed it. Yeah,
I missed it too.
I'm gonna have to go break this down tomorrow night. I'm gonna have to do some LiDAR of this 12 thing, right?
Hell, we're
gonna have to go into this. I don't know.
Do some right, black guys. Hole looking.
Okay.
That'll do it.
Some black hole looking shit.
Some black hole looking.
And people have these in their pockets.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Right?
Oh man, a black hole next to my nuts.
Cancer inducing.
Yeah, yeah.
Everybody out there, go hug someone.
Everything
go
is
hug
cancer.
Somebody.
Yes.
Give somebody a
hug. Remember, hugs
are not cancer inducing. They're the opposite.
Man. Hug them hard. Hug
go
that person
hug
hard.
Everyone.
Spread them hugs.
Yeah, spread them.
Exactly, Nikki.
Patreon.com/cruisewithsteak, shonendub.com. Yeah. Thanks for listening, guys.
Definitely.
We'll catch you all next week.
Bye.
Fuck
you
this
later.
Shit.
Feel back better.
Bye, everyone.
Bye.
Love you.
Imaginary lines, twisted and tangled. policy papers behind enemy lines. Tension builds, a cell phone rings, a bomb drops in a city street sea of iPod noise. Don't get comfortable, free thinkers. Don't get comfortable, free thinkers. If the digital revolution has still got a pulse, we need to revive it and make it a reality. I've hacked into a politician's password and transferred money into several overseas accounts. And as we speak, a supercomputer project is in the works. And if it works, we'll use it to point and click our way to some sort of truth. Either you're in or out, are you game, or is the game over?
This must be a glitch in the Matrix.
This must be a glitch in the Matrix. A revolutionary dream. It's no versus the machines.
Go! Watch out for them laser beams. Climb to the top of the pyramid scheme. Capitol Hill's getting steeper and steeper. Meanwhile, the deck gets deeper and deeper. Don't get comfortable, free thinkers. Cause it's gonna take more than hand and eye coordination on your PlayStation. It's gonna take mind elevation.
There must be a glitch in the Matrix. There must be a glitch in the Matrix. A revolutionary dream. It's me versus the machine. Computer screen swimming in us, a sea of zeros and ones. Trying to put together two and two, but I keep getting five. Trying to weave through all the lines from the bad guys in the suits and the neckties.
Help me find the oracle.
She has the answer. There must be a glitch in the Matrix. There must be a glitch in the Matrix. A revolutionary dream. Rage against the machine. Don't get comfortable, free thinkers. Rage against.